A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth. He had a message for a young woman promised in marriage to a man named Joseph, who was a descendant of King David. Her name was Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Peace be with you. The Lord is with you and has greatly blessed you." Mary was deeply troubled by the angel's message, and she wondered what his words meant. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God has been gracious to you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king, as his ancestor David was, and he will be the king of the descendants of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." Mary said to the angel, "I am a virgin. How can this be?" The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and God's power will rest upon you. For this reason, the Holy Child will be called the Son of God. Remember your relative Elizabeth. It is said that she cannot have children, but she herself is now 6 months pregnant, even though she is very old. For there is nothing that God cannot do." "I am the Lord's servant," said Mary. "May it happen to me as you have said." And the angel left her. The angel Gabriel was sent to Mary to tell her that she will have a son whom she will name Jesus. Mary was confused because she did not know how it could be possible since she was not yet married to Joseph. She was afraid because she would be judged by all the people around her. Yet Mary believed the angel's assurance and trusted that the Lord would see her through the journey. So she replied, "I am the Lord's servant. Let it be to me according to your word." She was faithful and obedient. We may not always fully understand why or how things will work out, and we may sometimes worry about the difficulties that we may face in our journey. Mary shows us that if we trust the Lord, he will see us through the journey. He will dispel our hesitations and fears, and he will give us the courage to say with Mary, "I am the Lord's servant. Let it be to me according to your word."